Actually, I was supposed to talk on contraception, but due to sponsor problems, I'm talking on something else, which is very important. It's a single umbilical artery, a condition to ponder about. I'm sure not only the obstetrician and gynecologist, everybody is looking at ultrasound reports nowadays. And when somebody says single umbilical artery, you might be wondering what it is. So it's very important.
Okay, got it.
Next. Okay, I'm just going to talk about a case first before we talk about single umbilical artery. We've got a 28-year-old lady. There are two deliveries, normal deliveries, one miscarriage, and this was the present pregnancy. Next slide. Corrected date of delivery by ultrasound was 10 weeks on 14th of August 2011. Next. She had an anomaly ultrasound. I'm not going to reveal where it was done. At 20 weeks, findings was single live entrial twin gestation, no congenital anomalies was detected. Next. Pregnancy was uncomplicated throughout. She had a weight gain of 12 kg. Normal pregnancy weight gain is around 11 to 12 kg. So this was quite normal. She was normotensive. All other investigations were within normal limits. Obstetric examination, clinically we felt this was a smaller baby. But as she had delivered small babies before, we thought it's a constitutional. Next. She had an ultrasound in the same center at 37 weeks. The findings was estimated fetal weight 2018 grams. Amniotic fluid index, which is 3 centimeters. You might know what is amniotic fluid. That is the amount of amniotic fluid which is around the fetus. Because this is mainly a process of absorption and excretion by the fetus. It says what is the condition of the fetus. Most of the time whenever there is AFA is less, there is some renal abnormalities. So, the fetal right kidney was not imaged. That was the report. Next. So, we have sent the patient to the tertiary center for repeat ultrasound. Next. So, the findings were single live entrial gestation, 39 weeks, cephalic presentation, two loops of cord, the side of the fetal neck. Umbilical cord shows two vessels. Normally, there are three vessels in the umbilical cord. Here they have showed only two vessels. Baby's weight was 2.2 kg and showed severe intermittent growth resection. Fetal right kidney was not visualized. Thick wall fetal bladder, severe oligohydramnios, 2 cm, normal Doppler. Next. Patient was counseled by the sonologist who did the scan. Go to the hospital immediately and you need to have cesarean section. I'm going to ask Sai about it. We tried to tell the patient that we will wait till the next day because CTG was normal. Okay, there is no hurry and we didn't have senior people in the afternoon. We didn't want to do anything in a hurry. And the induced labor to achieve vaginal delivery, as there is the possibility of more anomalies in a single umbilical artery. But patient was so agitated and tense that she demanded immediate cesarean section. Patient and husband also insisted on tubal ligation along with cesarean section. We delivered a live baby with multiple anomalies with abgas 6 and 8 by cesarean section. Findings abnormal fishes, pot belly abdomen with wrinkled skin, micropenis, bilateral undissected testes, hypospadias, imperforate anus, single umbilical artery. Next. See the baby. There are some pictures of the baby. This is the pot belly abdomen, imperforate anus, single umbilical artery. Baby had multiple anomalies. Okay, next. We have shown the baby to the mother and because we do most of our sections with the spinal or sometimes the epidural, we showed the baby to the mother and also to her husband. We said we don't want to do tubal ligation, but they were insisting on tubal ligation. So much we talked, like the doctor who did the surgery, she came out and talked and everybody talked, but they said definitely they want it. So it was done. After taking your own this consent. Okay, next. In view of the multiple anomalies, baby was still alive. They were transferred to Institute of Child Health for tertiary care. They cannot afford to go to Medhas Hospital. Okay, next. Baby was sent back after a few days. Diagnosis, Prion-Willi syndrome. Colostomy was done in the ICH and was sent back to the mother. Condition of the baby was explained by them. Baby expired after a few days. So, let us see what is single umbilical artery. normally we have got the umbilical cord, there are two arteries and one vein. And the two arteries carrying a deoxygenated blood and vein is carrying an oxygenated blood. So vein is carrying oxygenated blood from the placenta to the fetus. Arteries are carrying deoxygenated blood from fetus to the placenta. Next please. A typical umbilical cord has two arteries and one vein. Vein carries oxygenated blood and the arteries carry deoxygenated blood. Umbilical arteries are the only arteries in the human body, aside from the pulmonary arteries, that carry deoxygenated blood. Okay, next please. Incidence is around 1 in 100 to 1 in 500 pregnancy. So this is the most common umbilical abnormality. It's more common in multiple births, its cause is not known. I have also seen two cases. That single umbilical artery was in one baby, other baby was alright and that baby died. The other baby was alright, that was normal. Next. In about 75% of the cases, fetus is entirely normal and healthy. And my experience is otherwise. They almost 75% with that anomalous babies. In 25%, this is the literature, single umbilical artery is a sign that the fetus also has other abnormalities, sometimes life-threatening and sometimes not. So single umbilical artery does increase the risk of baby having heart, skeletal, intestinal and kidney problems. Etiology is said to be multifactorial. Out of the two umbilical arteries, one has atrophied, or from persistence of the normally transient early embryonic single umbilical artery which divides into two. So persistent of that. Okay, next. By ultrasound, this condition can be identified in one of two ways. Mostly by visualizing a cross section of the umbilical cord and noting the number of vessels, most of the sonologists do that. Next. So where we have seen the three vessels, two arteries and one vein. Yeah, next. Here we are seeing only two vessels. Next. See only two vessels. Second artery is missing. This should be apparent by the time the umbilical ultrasound is performed, typically between 18 to 22 weeks. The ultrasonologists take care to visualize the umbilical cord in all the cases. Next. Given that the majority of the expectant mothers do not receive the kind of advanced ultrasound scanning required to confirm single umbilical artery in utero, most cases may never be detected annually even today, because all these fuzzy tertiary centers and all those things are only in the major cities. What about the villages where they are doing preliminary scans, level 1 scan, no scan? I think most of these babies are not detected. So single umbilical artery does increase the risk of high fetus having cardiac, skeletal, GI tract and kidney anomalies. 1998 meta-analysis said renal anomalies were the most common, accounting for 16% of total anomalies. Next. That is why perception that renal anomalies are particularly common and led some people to recommend postnatal renal evaluation for all infants with single umbilical artery. However, a careful neonatal examination of all the systems are essential. Next. High incidence of single umbilical artery is also found when looking at a group of aborted and stillborn fetuses. After that, at least 10 of my mothers have come. They all had abnormalities, they had single umbilical artery. So fortunately, nowadays it is detected early. They come for early termination. Then if the baby is non-amblic, then intrauterine growth retardation is observed in 15 to 18% of cases. Baseline rate is 10%. So twice the number of fetuses have got growth restriction. Next. So how are you going to manage this patient? First, if there is single umbilical artery, you have to do a high-level ultrasound scans to look for other associated anomalies. Also, you have to look for aneuploidy to find out whether any chromosomal anomalies. So you have to do an echocardiogram to find out whether there is an abnormality of the heart. Next. Managing a pregnancy. If no abnormality is found, then the fetus is presumed to have isolated single umbilical artery. But still, this pregnancy has to be followed up. The baby has to be followed up after delivery. Genetic counseling is maybe useful too, especially in weighing the pros and cons of more invasive procedures, such as serious amniocentesis. If you are going to do a cardiosynthesis for detection of anomalies, detection of chromosome anomalies. Next. Third trimester ultrasound, fetal growth, and initiate fetal testing like Doppler's and cardiac topography if the growth is not appropriate. As we said already, 18% of babies, they don't have appropriate growth. So we have to do all these tests and follow them up. Next. In spite of all the things, as like the previous case, it's impossible to be completely certain that fetus has no malformations, even if none is seen on ultrasound. So extensive counseling of the mother is important. Probably we are not able to see some small anomalies. Try everything, baby has to be examined after birth, and then only we can give a final verdict. Next. Thorough counseling is most important in managing these pregnancies. Then I have got a few questions for Sai, who is going to talk for a few minutes. Which is the most suitable time to look for number of vessels in the umbilical cord? Next. Who should counsel the patient when an abnormality is noticed? Obstetric gynecology ultrasound or other imaging modalities? Either a sonologist, radiologist, or OBGYN specialist? Are there any guidelines about it? Next. What is the earliest time to detect abnormalities in an obstetric ultrasound? And what is the ideal time? Next. Do you recommend biochemical test to all the patients in Indian setting? Because we know we are doing triple test, quadruple test, each costs 3,000 rupees, 4,000 rupees. Well, most of the women, they are not even able to have one simple ultrasound. Because India is full of villages, and only few metro cities, they have all fussy investigations, but most of the women, they don't have. So is it going to be cost effective for India? Next. Well, if you detect something, is it possible to send a note to OBGYN about the anomaly and implications if it is difficult to call, so that proper counseling can be done? I know some centers, they counsel completely, send the patient, so it is easy for us to talk. In other centers, they won't say anything, go and see your doctor. Then you have to go to the literature and see what is the problem and all those things. So it's, I think Dr. Sai has to, I want Sai to say something on these questions. Next. Let us now, today is the day where we have to mourn and pray to Almighty that India will become a safe country for women at least in future. I request all the members of IMA Kodambakam to stand up for a minute to show our solidarity that this sort of brutality will never occur in India again. I put a figure. I put this because I put this in New Zealand, an event in New Zealand. The Chinese New Year they are celebrating because this looks very much like a political photo. Thank you.
Thank you very much, madam. Actually, this is a very important topic, that single umbilical artery, we are seeing it nowadays very frequently, and it has been a very, very important one to look for this single umbilical artery. Before answering all your questions, I thought I'll show you a few slides which are literature, what is telling. That is, basically, when we do ultrasound, this is the fetoplacental circulation. When you take up arteries we will see for an umbilical artery, middle cerebral artery, and ductus arteriosus artery. And in the veins, we will see for an umbilical vein and an IVC. Shunt between this is the ductus venosus, foramen ovale, and the ductus arteriosus. This is the fetoplacental circulation. Next slide. See, this is what the madam has already pointed out, this one. You see here. See, this is the urinary bladder of the fetus. On either side of the urinary bladder, the two arteries are entering into the fetus. That is, two umbilical arteries are present. That is like a twisted rope, it will be there. But if there is, it is only a single umbilical artery on either side of the bladder, we are seeing only one artery which is going on this side is absent. That is typical of a single umbilical artery. It will have, vein will be larger and the artery will be smaller. So this appearance is for the single umbilical artery, whereas this is for the two umbilical arteries and one umbilical vein will be there. That is two umbilical arteries and this is a single umbilical vein will be there. So this side is a normal one, this is a single umbilical artery and vein. Next. Can be diagnosed at 12 weeks of gestation, this single umbilical artery, but highest rate of detection will be between 17 to 35 weeks because it will be appearing like a parallel and it's not like a twisted one, single umbilical artery, and it will result in 15 to 20% of the babies will be a IUGR and 22% will go for a miscarriage and 25% have a birth defects like a cardiac, renal and gastrointestinal tract. Next. one study has taken place, 80 cases this person has done it, and 26% anomalies are prenatally diagnosed, whereas 43% are detected postnatally. So the postnatal detection is more than the prenatal diagnosis in a single umbilical artery. Next. Several studies depicted this single umbilical artery is associated with the IUGR, intrauterine growth restricted fetus, or a preterm delivery, stillbirth, prematurity, and the congenital anomalies like cardiac, gastrointestinal tract, or the renal anomalies. There are studies which has refuted there is no IUGR risk and no preterm delivery. Next. One meta-analysis has taken place from 1990 to 2007. In that, so many deliveries, in that single umbilical artery was 392. Isolated single umbilical artery is 281. And 111 associated with the malformations like all these cardiac anomalies, renal anomalies, and the musculoskeletal anomalies. So the more maximum will be the renal anomalies, 6.48%. So, fetuses and neonates with a single umbilical artery and isolated single umbilical artery are increased risk for adverse outcomes. Identification of a single umbilical artery is important for prenatal diagnosis of a congenital anomalies and aneuploidy. Increased surveillance with an isolated single umbilical artery may improve the pregnancy outcome. This is what the conclusion of that meta-analysis. Close. See, what madam was asking, first case which she has shown, can I see your slides?
Yeah, sure.
The first case, it was a oligohydramnios, Prun-Willi syndrome. So once the oligohydramnios, if the amniotic fluid index is coming less than 5 cm, will allow the patient go immediately to the obstetrician.
Which slide do you want? Which slide do you want?
Go, go. Yeah,
this one. 3 centimeters.
You want the questions?
No, this baby first, this one.
Okay, finish the baby. Yeah. Just switch on the lights and come back.
See, this is typical. The Prun-Willi syndrome, the etiopathology of this Prun-Willi syndrome is there is some obstruction will be there at the lower end when the development of the kidney, ureter, and at the urethra level. Verum montanum area, there is some obstruction is there. That obstruction, if it is not relieved, what will happen? Urinary bladder will go on distending. That back pressure change, ureter will be distended. And the back pressure change, like kidneys also will get dilated. So when that is taking place, that will not allow this anterior wall of the abdomen to develop. So this is wrinkling of the skin will take place. And that one also, if it is a male child, descent of the testis from abdomen to the down, to the tear, that also will get arrested because of this distension. So these three components will be there in case of a Prun-Willi syndrome. One is the dilated ureters with the kidneys. Second one will be the undescended testes, and third one will be the wrinkling of the anterior abdominal, because development will be arrested because of the fluid is completely there in the bladder and the ureters are there. So that is what has happened. That will take, see, kidneys will develop at 12 weeks. Then we go on, we have to do a serial scan. Here in this case, what has happened is 12 weeks it was done, 20 weeks it was done, then 37 weeks only it was done. So in between 20 and 37 weeks, all this has happened. And most of the time, depending upon the position of the fetus, the anomalies finding is very difficult. All the anomalies cannot be detected unless you deliver it and then you turn this side, that side, and then see the baby, then only you will see the anomalies. So that is what has happened in this case. And a suitable time to detect for the single umbilical artery, I said 12 weeks you can see, but when you are doing anomaly scan, 18 to 22 weeks, at that time you put a color Doppler in the fetal bladder area, you will see two arteries which is going on either side of the bladder, that is two umbilical artery. That confirms that is a two umbilical. Only one artery alone is seen, that is single umbilical artery. Who should counsel the patient? best will be the obstetrician. Because we radiologist will be seeing for a time, for a few minutes only the patient, best will be the obstetrician. And nowadays, for fetal anomalies, fetal MRI, it's a non-invasive, no radiation, nothing is there. At the 37 weeks also, three-dimensionally you'll get most of the anomalies you can pick up with the fetal MRI.
So, where is it being done?
From all 1.5 Tesla, wherever the MRI is there, everybody is doing.
Malar also being
done. Scan ball and everything.
Yes, yes.
Fetal MRI.
Our center, it is 3,500.
They do 3Ds,
no? Yeah. Video. Yeah. Coronal, sagittal, and.
You can see the babies.
Right? Yes. Yes. Because it is complementary to one each other. 3D ultrasound and the fetal MRI. Now the fetal MRI is scoring over the 3D ultrasound.
Is it done in Maharashtra?
Everywhere now the fetal MRI is picking up, sir.
The positive
diagnosis
is very
general
by the ordinary
UNG. What's the
it is possible to diagnose this case in the periphery by the only ordinary UNG is available.
Yes, I know, well, it's a color Doppler. Color Doppler mission. Nowadays in periphery and all, I have visited a lot of places. They are having better machines than what we are having here. Yes, see, if they are having a 70 lakhs machine and all, then
running it off the.
We wanted to give a best to this district. I have to practice in this place. So I have to give our best, so you give me the best. So they are having a 70 lakhs machine. And you can diagnose.
I don't understand what you're saying. You are going to.
They are coming regularly to the CME programs. Nowadays they are all very well
versed.
Internet is there. Every day they will sit in the computer and then look for the quizzes. So definitely. Yes. Yes.
With the development of technological medicine and multiple partnership with treating, who is to tell to the patient what is one of the very important questions? Now I very humbly request the investigation of colleagues, even though the technology is superior in handling the patients, the final decision should be only in the hands of the patients. So I give briefly 1 minute one example. A 78-year-old man came with a massive problem patient, right? Said we put ICD immediately and then sent for all the investigations. They came, they say that they said the identification of adenocarcinomatous cells by the pathologist. Then after the training, of course, you don't take MRI or HRCT in rural patient there, you will be only when the fluid is tamped. After free breathing completely tamped, we went for HRCT and the report was hypnosis, calcification and small cyst, and then loss of the volume, traction, everything, and finally given tuberculosis. Then the person took cut.
You wanted to take some time and download. Why is that?
Yes, previously,
how do I pull it off?
And what the
how do I pull it in the other
ones are now well, correct. But the thing is, whether it is active or inactive is decided by yes or no. But unfortunately, he took otherwise. The person was spread and gave. Of course, I think would have been an adenocarcinoma, I think, where to God and the case. Chemotherapy, he did this one aspect of the situation. Therefore, the final interpretation hands of the clinician. It's very, very important. I humbly request to seek the cooperation of our amazing colleagues to be cooperating with us.
Dr. Sai, what I want to say is, Mediscan, they come to all the patients. So when they come to us, you know, it's like a double information and it makes our life easy. Then we send to some other center and they don't say anything. But recently I had some patient who got a very rare cyst. No, the sonologist didn't know exactly about it. I asked a pediatrician, she didn't know. I didn't know, I went to the net and not complete information. So I don't know what to say. Fortunately, she went to the labor next day, something like this. So not that we are not able to say everything about all the anomalies, because all the time I'm with the computer and the laptop. So double counseling will help us.